So we've got a logic statement here at the top, and we've got to turn this into a logic circuit. Okay, so the thing to do first up is just figure out what we've got in the statement. Okay, now the thing on the left hand side is going to be the output. Okay, so we know in the actual logic circuit, this is the thing we're going to see last. Okay, now what's then helpful is to underline to yourself the different gates that are going to be used. So we can see here we've got OR, and NOT. Okay, so if we were to start off with the output at the end, which is Q, so I'm going to kind of work backwards here. And then what we're going to do, we know that the inputs, okay, so the inputs are going to be A, B, and C. Okay, so they're the things that have got to go on this side. So if we do A, B, and C, and I've just written them like that because A and B are together in the same gate, and C is by itself in its own gate. Okay, and we can see the gates that are being used here for A and B. It's an OR gate. So we could go ahead and draw an OR gate here. Okay, so my drawing isn't very good here. There we go. So there's an OR gate. I always remember it's an OR gate because this bit looks a bit like that bit in an R. Okay. Undo that. Okay, so we've got our OR gate done. There we go, done that bit. Now we've got to do the this part, the end bit, so NOT C. Okay, so we know this is a NOT gate, so we'll draw a NOT gate like that. Okay, so what we've done there, we've used the OR gate, we've used the NOT gate, so we're just left with the AND gate. Okay, so we're going to have these two inputs here, and these are going to go into our AND gate. This drawing is not great. You'd probably set this out better if you were doing this. So here we go. So we've got our logic statement turned into a logic circuit. Okay, so A or B. Okay, there's our OR gate. And NOT C equals Q. Okay, so then we could go ahead and then draw our truth table from that. Okay, so we put our inputs in, A, B, C, and we put our output, which is Q. Okay, now I'm not going to draw the whole truth table here because we could be here for a very long time. Let's just redraw that. So let's say A and B were 0 and C was 0. So if you're doing this in the exam, I'd recommend maybe just with a pencil, just putting the inputs up here because it just makes your life a bit easier. Okay, so we've got an OR gate for A and B. So the output there, one has got to be positive for the output to be positive, but as they're both negative, the output's going to be negative. And for the NOT gate, remember it reverses the input. So we're getting that into our AND gate, 0 and 1, and both have to be true for being an AND gate. So our output for Q in that case is going to be 0. Okay, I'll do one more so you can sort of see. Let's do that one. So just rub out that and we'll put a 1. So A is 1, B is 0, so because it's an OR gate, the output will be positive there, because as long as one is positive, then the output will be positive. There we go. And same for C, we can see here C is 0, so that will reverse the output. So 1 and 1 are output, because it's an AND gate, both have to be positive. 1 and 1 is going to be 1. Okay, and so on, but I'm not going to do the whole thing because, like I say, it would take a while, but you get the idea. So that's how to transfer a logic statement into a logic circuit.